Hello students, today we are going to see about the topic of secondary memory units or secondary devices. Okay, these are one of the components of computer system. Okay, what is secondary storage devices? As I already told you in previous videos, primary storage devices are only have a limited storage capacity. It is not a permanent place for store. Okay, but the secondary storage devices is just opposite to the primary devices, because we can store lot and lot of informations in the secondary storage devices. This secondary storage devices are store the information permanently. Okay, that's why we can say this secondary storage devices called backup storage, because it backup the information for future purpose. This secondary storage is also known as external memory or ancillary storage. These secondary storage devices are not directly accessible by the CPU, but primary storage devices are directly accessible by the CPU. We will see one by one what are the secondary storage devices. There are different types of secondary storages or available secondary storage devices are available. So these are the secondary storage devices. These are the updations of secondary storage devices: hard disk, floppy, CD-ROM, DVD, pen drive, Blu-rays. So these are the various types of secondary storage devices used by many users nowadays. The first one we are going to see, floppy disk. So this is the image of floppy disk. So the floppy disk is one of the secondary storage devices. This is the first floppy disk. Okay, this is an 8-inch floppy disk. It hold 256 kilobyte data in it. Okay, next generations were 5.25 inches in diameter. It is just little compared to the first floppy disk. It again have a capacity to hold 1.44 megabyte. Megabyte is called MB. Okay, it is a standard floppy disk. Then the next generation of floppy disk inventor. Then the next generation, third generation of floppy disk inches is 3.5. This floppy disk are held within the plastic case for protection. This disk is very protective under this plastic case. This third generation of floppy disk can hold the space of 2.88 MB. This floppy disk is one of the oldest type of portable storage devices. These floppy disk is still in use, but so many new inventions are came, but still it is used by some users. This floppy disk is used to transfer very small amount of information between the computers. Okay, this is also used to store data as a backup file. Okay, but for large amount of data, this floppy disk is not convenient. So a standard floppy disk can store 1.44 MB of data. 1.44 MB means, for example, A4 pages. Okay, in the A4 pages, it can store 300 A4 pages data can be stored in the floppy disk. Okay, the size is 300 pages of A4 sheet. Data can be saved in the floppy disk. But compared to text, this floppy disk is take more space for graphics and pictures. Okay, if you are saving the text, it only take a small space to store, but compared to graphics and pictures, it takes more space compared to the text. So here all the floppy disk or diskettes are formatted before data can be written in the floppy disk. Here formatting means marking and dividing the disk into a different units. So the floppy disk are dividing itself into tracks and sector. Okay, it dividing into two tracks and sector. So the disk are dividing into two types. Concentric circle is called the tracks, and then the track is also subdivided into two sectors, that is tracks and sector. I will show you the image of floppy disk and the part of floppy disk. Okay, so this is the image of floppy disk. So these are the floppy disk parts: plastic flap, spring, magnetic disk, shutter, paper ring, everything is there. So these are the seven internal parts of floppy disk. So these seven internal parts of floppy disk are very important. If anything damaged, then the floppy disk cannot work properly. Next one, hard disk. So the hard disk is one of the types of secondary storage devices. So the hard disk drive is a data storage device. It is the updation of floppy disk. Okay, this hard disk store and retrieve the digital information by rotating its disk. Okay, while data are stored, the disk are rotated. Okay, this rotating disk are coated or covered with magnetic material. All the informations are recorded in the bands. The bands are the internal parts of hard disk. Okay, this band of information is placed in the disk. Okay, this disk is called the track, and then this track is also subdivided into pie shaped section. This pie shaped section is called the sector. Okay, so band, and then track, and then sector. And then in the hard disk there is a motor. Okay, that motor is rotate the disk at a rapid speed. All the data we are entering in it are recorded on the tracks. So this is the image of hard disk. This is invented after the floppy disk. Next one is CD-ROM. This is one of the secondary storage devices. CD-ROM means compact disk read only memory. CDs are a optical media. It is very cheap compared to the floppy disk and hard disk. It is very cheap and it have a large size of capacity to store the data, up to 700 megabyte. Okay, the compact disk read only memory is used only to store information. So many manufacturers are use the CD-ROM. Okay, use the CD-ROM to record the information like text, graphics, audio, musics, etc. They are store the information in the CD and they are sell to the customers. We all know what is CD. Musics, movies were stored in the compact disc and sell by the manufacturers to the customers. Okay, let's we see what do you mean by CD-ROM. As its name implies, CD-ROM is a compact disc read-only memory. It can be read by the computer with an optical drive, but it cannot be altered or erased. Okay, because it is a read-only memory. Here the name ROM, R-O-M, means read-only. Okay, we cannot altered or erased. CD-ROM is attached with the computer or laptops. Okay, when you pressing a button, a CD ROM is come out. We can put a CD and we can see what is there it may be a music or movie, right? But we cannot erase or altered in the CD-ROM. The discs are created or made up of aluminium, which is sandwiched. Sandwiched means up and down between plastic. Okay. So in the CD-ROM, we can record the data in the CD only once. But after the data are recorded, we cannot alter or erase. CD-ROM, just imagine if there are two parts, okay, you can write in one part in only one time, and then you can write in the another part at a later time, but you cannot alter or erase. If you once write the CD, you cannot erase or rewrite on the CD-ROM. Next one, CD rewritable. It is the updation of CD in which these CDs are erasable disc. This rewritable CD, as its name implies, you can write it on a multiple times like floppy or hard disk. Okay, its main advantage is you can write more time. But if you do many times, I mean if you erase many times, then the CD will fads. Okay, it's not a clarity one. Even it is a rewritable one, if you are erasing so many times, the quality will not be very standard and good. Next one is DVD. So this DVD is also one of the secondary storage devices. This DVD is also an optical storage devices, and it is look like as a CD. This DVD is also called super density disc because it can hold the 17 gigabytes of data. Okay, it can store large amount of data compared to the floppy disk, hard disk and even a CD. This DVD is better when compared to the CD. It is 20 times faster than the CD-ROM. Okay, these DVDs were originally developed for the purpose of movie industry because these DVDs can have a capacity to read audio, compactable disc read-only memory, compactable disc recording, compactable disc rewritable storage devices, etc. Capacity of DVD-ROM is 4.7 GB to maximum 17 GB. It is very convenient for users compared to the CD. Next one, DVD or DVD recording. It is just like CD or we can write on the DVD or recording or only once, but we can read many times. Die layer is used for data writing in the DVD recordable. Next one, DVD rewritable. This is also like a CD rewritable. In this DVD rewritable, we can erase and read many times. Okay, these DVD rewritable discs are more convenient nowadays. Next one, pen drive. We all know what is pen drive because nowadays so many persons have their pen drives because it is very compatible, okay, and convenient to all of us. This pen drive is also known as USB flash drive. It is a portable data storage device, that is, it is a wireless one. Okay. After the pen drive comes to the world, it can replace the floppy drives of old. And this pen drive is more popular one in the storage devices among so many consumers. Because this pen drive is very little in space. It is a micro, very lightweight and it is very handy in nature. That's why so many customers are like pen drives. A pen drives can be easily taken from place to place by students, professionals, academicians, consultant, and so many persons are likes pen drives because it is a handy in nature. Pen drives are of in different rates, depends upon the sizes. Okay, so currently pen drives are available from 4 GB to 32 GB. Okay, it can store large amount of data. This pen drive can store graphics, heavy documents, photos, music files, video clips, movies. So many things can save in the pen drive very easily. I will show you the internal part of pen drive. So this is the internal part of pen drive. Here USB controller, circuit board, various components are there. So these are the designs and the internal parts of pen drive. These internal parts should be very important. If anything damaged, then pen drive will not be work properly. Okay, what is the main advantages of pen drive is, it's very affordable because it is in very different size, like from 4 MB to 32 GB. Depends upon the cost, we can buy the pen drive. Consumers are like pen drive compared to the other storage devices because it is very handy, and pen drives are free from scratches like dust, magnetic field, etc. Okay, next one, what are the disadvantages of pen drive? So the disadvantages means, we can say virus attack. Yes, if you are insert a pen drive in a virus laptops, then if you are inserting the same pen drive into the normal virus free laptops, that laptops also affected through virus. That is the main disadvantages of pen drive. Main drawback is, the pen drives are looks very small. Okay, so sometimes it may misplaced by user or may have a chance to lose the pen drive. Then if you are improperly insert the USB or pen drive, it will damage the internal parts. These are the images of pen drive with different sizes. Okay, nowadays there are so many models, there are so many shapes or comes in the pen drives. Kids and students are much attractive to buy different models and different sizes of pen drive. Next one is Blu-ray disc. This is one of the secondary memory storage devices. This is the images. It is just look like CD or DVD. This Blu-ray disc is a optical disc storage medium. Okay, it is same like DVD and CD. This Blu-ray disc is developed by Blu-ray Disc Association. Blu-ray Disc Associations are Apple, Hitachi, HP, LG, Panasonic, Pioneer. So these are the companies. These companies are called Blu-ray Disc Associations. Okay, these associations are created this Blu-ray disc. Why the name is called blue means, here the laser color is blue. Here the blue color laser is used in the Blu-ray disc. Okay, the Blu-ray disc comes in a different formats. So these are the four formats of Blu-ray. It is just like CD-ROM, DVD-ROM. This also comes in different formats: Blu-ray disc read-only, Blu-ray disc decodable, Blu-ray disc rewritable, Blu-ray disc rewritable for HDTV. These are the generations of Blu-ray disc formats. Okay,
This Blu-ray disc is classified into two layer. One is single layer and another one is double layer. The double layer is more quality than single layer. Okay, single layer hold the space from 25 to 27 GP. That means 2 hours of HD video. But compared to double layer, the double layers can hold the data up to 50 GB. 50 GB means 2.5 hours of HD videos or more than 20 hours of standard video. The single layer is a quality Blu-ray disc, but compared to the double layer, it is just little standard. But the double layer is one of the best Blu-ray disc layer. So these are the features of Blu-ray disc. Okay, this Blu-ray disc can record HDTV without any quality loss. Okay, in the Blu-ray disc, you can record one program while watching another program on the disc. This is the special features of Blu-ray. You can create playlist in the Blu-ray disc. Okay, in the Blu-ray, you can edit or reorder programs you already recorded on disc. Okay, I will show you the capacity of Blu-ray and DVD. So this is the Blu-ray and DVD capacity. This is a comparison image of CD versus DVD versus Blu-ray disc. One is better than another one. These are the Blu-ray disc products. Okay, these products are Blu-ray disc products. Last one, magnetic tape. Okay, this is the image of magnetic tape. We all know what is magnetic tape. Okay, this magnetic tape is used to store a large amount of data. Okay, this is one of the medium of recording which is consist of a thin tape. This tape is coating of a fine or good magnetic material. We can use the radio and put this cassette to the radio and playing musics. Before CDs, DVDs, Blu-rays comes and pen drives comes, this magnetic tapes are very popular. And so many users are buys these magnetic tapes. Okay girls, these are the secondary memory storage devices. I hope you all of you understand. If you have any doubts, please ask me. Thank you.